All right, rise and shine, everyone. Welcome to your weekend. Jason and Alicia here with you, waking up to what is a chilly morning.
This is April in Minnesota. Yeah. I have to like remind you, you're still new here.
Yeah, I've been here for a year, but still getting used to certain things.
April, John, right? This is somewhat normal.
Yeah, it is. I mean, April's kind of like it's a transition month. You have 85 and then you have 35. So we just dropped 50 degrees from Saturday. No big deal. Freeze warning is in effect. How this works, always confusing. Why is a northern Minnesota habit? Growing season hasn't technically started yet. So that's why southern Minnesota could see temperatures around 30. Got the frost advisory near La Crosse. Temperatures are right around the freezing mark, 34. I think it's more of a frost than a freeze. You really need to be in the 20s for a freeze. Nonetheless, you would have to put out weak or sensitive vegetation to have impacts to this. Tulips are good. 29 in Alexandria, 28 in Bemidji, 30 in Wilmer. The winds are pretty strong right now, so that is a problem. Oh, there's also flurries. No accumulation, but it lets you know today's a chilly day. We'll talk about a warmer weekend in your forecast. Cece.
Good morning. Live look here at 94 eastbound at Snelling Avenue. Roads looking great. Traffic picking up slightly here at 6 o'clock. See Allianz Field there. Good morning if you're waking up in that area. Now, if you're taking 94 on your commute either into Minneapolis or St. Paul this morning, drive time's looking about average for this time of morning, 7 to 8 minutes. I will be talking about some construction when I see you here next. But as you're headed out the door here this morning, let me know your specific morning route and I can tell you what roads are looking like in your area. Hashtag CC's commute on social.
All right, CC, thank you very much. We're following breaking news here out of the Middle East at 6:02. U.S. officials are confirming Israel has carried out a military strike against Iran.
The impact of the strike is still being assessed, but we do know explosions were reported in Isfahan. That's just south of the capital city, Tehran. We have brand new video from inside Iran of the attack. Now, the move comes in response to Iran's attack last weekend that saw more than 300 drones and missiles launched at Israel. Just hours ago, NBC talked with a former CIA director about what could happen next.
I do not believe at this point that Iran wants a major war, because it will lose that and it will lose it in a big way. But at the same time, the Iranian leadership also has to face its domestic political pressure. And it can't be seen as just laying down to Israel's offensive capabilities.
This attack comes days after President Biden urged Israel to use restraint. We, of course, will be following this breaking story all morning and updating you both on air and online as new information comes in. All right, 6:03 is your time. Switching gears to a big story here in Minnesota. In just over 24 hours, the Timberwolves will take the court for game one of their playoff series against the Phoenix Suns.
And the Wolves are trying to do something that they haven't done in two decades, 20 years. We're talking about just making it out of the first round. Now, tickets are still available. If you're looking at SeatGeek, you'll pay anywhere from $61 to $365. Tip-off is at 2:30 over at Target Center. And that's where Michelle Beck is right now, breaking down the series for us. Michelle, good morning.
Yeah, Jason, Alicia, good morning to you. There's so much here on the line. The Timberwolves are so excited to host and, of course, start off with this home court advantage, as are the fans, as expected. As of this morning, tickets are still available for tomorrow's game.